Okay, today we represent with aircraft, which means wind and ground effect aircraft. Okay, I will introduce my two members. The first one is Ain Sabrina binti Chahul Zahri. The second one is Nur Basira binti Basri. And the third one is Nur Fauziana binti Muhammad Ridwan. Okay, the fourth one is Nur Atikah Syazwani binti Rahimi. And the last one is me, Muhammad Ibrahim bin Murabi.
My name is Nur Rashida
binti
Basri and I'm going to explain about introduction of wind in ground effect. Ground effect is the enhanced force performance of a lifting surface. In fixed wind aircraft, ground effect increase lift force and increase aerodynamic that generate aircraft wind close to a fixed surface. Give the pilot feeling the aircraft floating while landing and temporarily reduce the stall speed while taking off. The context, the implication of ground effect, we got two, fixed wing and rotary wing. For fixed wing, ground effect not necessarily move away from runway, and existence of this effect not be reliable something. For rotary wing, main interest is reduced power required to hover in ground effect. Blade tip or vortex may disturb adjacent and secure ground equipment. And for the last is control surface of adjacent wing force again to stop with potential damage. So for the rules and regulation, I pass to Ain Sabrina.
Assalamualaikum. So I'm Sabrina. I will proceed for the rules and regulation of wing in ground effect. For the safety and certificate, director must request to the flight administration of any contracting party for foreign aircraft to be surveyed. And the second one is the requirement is to authorize the issue of a windproof safety certificate. And for the permit, director will only release the permit for the wing craft to operate if it satisfies all the guidelines and conditions. And last one, inspection. For the inspection, a wing craft at the Singapore shall be inspected by the director, postmaster, surveyor of a ship, or any officer that been authorized by the director or postmaster. So the inspections include all the guidelines which are valid endorsed of wing craft safety certificate, and it also a valid endorsed permit to operate wing craft.
Okay, assalamualaikum. My name is Nur Fauziana binti Muhammad Ridwan. Now I would like to continue to explain about the classification of WIG. There are three type A, B, and C. Type A, where a craft which is certified for operation only in ground effect. It provides general information which is applicable to all the craft. For next, type B, a craft which is certified for temporary, increase its altitude to a limited height outside the influence the ground effect, but not exceeding 150 meters above the surface. Besides, it also includes the prescriptive requirements that may be subordinate as to measure the development through the safety assessment recommendations of the Part C. Next is the Type C, where a craft which is certified for the operation outside of the ground effect and exceeding 150 meters above the surface. It tells the details about the safety assessment required for all the craft. IMO and ICAO have agreed that any WIG craft capable of sustained flight outside the influence of the ground effect should also be subject to the IMO rules and regulations of ICAO. Thank you.
Okay, this is the list of wind ground vehicles around the world. First one is Australia. They have single six wind endowed aircraft. Then China, PSF 100 Tianyi-1, 15-seat wing endowed aircraft. Then France, an Avian designed and built by Serge Panek and Airbus. Germany, TAF B2, 2-seat. Then Iran, Baba 2, 2-seater. And then Korea, CLS AMT Aero-7. Russia, Evolga EK-12, Berif B1, experimental aircraft used in development of UVA routine. And then Singapore, F8001, AFH. And the last one is United States, Boeing Unikai. Thank you.
Assalamualaikum, my name is Ratika Shazwani Pendrahimi. Can call me Atik. I will present to you the conclusion of the wing aircraft. So it was clear about what Malaysia has to do. So wing aircraft is that we conclude that wing aircraft is actually safer and environment friendly. Since the fuel right now, the fuel might be able to cover all the usage of aircraft. But in the future, they might can fulfill the needs since the aviation industry is getting bigger and bigger. So besides that, the fuel that we are using now on the normal aircraft, it might cause damage to the environment. For example, fuel dumping. And Singapore is a smaller state and they use it to fly it internationally. So since Malaysia is a bigger state, so there are more region and why not. So we can use the wing aircraft to fly domestically and also internationally. And yeah, so to conclude that Malaysia have to emphasize the wing aircraft because there might be a lot of procedure like have to be approved by the Ministry of Transport and have all the regulations. But this is for the sake of the future where it is environment and energy efficient. So it make the environment of Malaysia itself is cleaner and safer.